Now we're going to look at a piece of music called Without You, composed by Josh Nelson and arranged by Gerhard Guter. What sticks out to me right away about this song is the depth of the lyric content. And I actually have a hard time believing that Josh composed it before the pandemic, because it was the first song I had my choir sing coming out of the pandemic. And as I get into the lyrics, you're going to see why. The first verse simply says, "Return to you, return to your life. Come back to your past, come back to that time that went so fast."
Return to you, return to your life, come back to your past, come back to that time that went so fast.
So let's dig into the vocal tone that you'll be primarily using as you execute this in your choir. The lyric is very personal. It's very intimate. You're talking about encouraging a person to come out of their shell, and I'm not going anywhere without you until you get back to normal. If you were saying that to a person, you would not use a loud, combative vocal tone. You would say, "Return to you, return to your life, come back to the past." You would use that kind of tone. And so if you listen to the tone that I'm using when I'm talking, it doesn't have a lot of edge on it. It doesn't have a lot of depth and openness to it. It's kind of right here. So if you think of the old Campbell's soup where they said, good. And just think about where that M is. Now, don't put it up in your nose. Don't go, it's not there, right? It's forward placed, but it bypasses the nose. So I think of it as forward and down, like shooting out of my bottom teeth. Everybody say, good. Now, if you... the lyrics of Without You say, "Return to you, return to your life." It's very warm. There's no vibrato. It's exactly how I speak. And then I'm just going to do that on pitch. Return to you, return to your life. Notice it's not breathy. I'm not introducing return to, nothing like that. Return to you. It absolutely has the proper core to the vocal sound and the tone. It's just not projecting very much. And that's because in jazz, we have the microphone right here. So I can use that microphone to get very intimate with the audience. Try that with me once. One, two, three, four. Return to you. And right off on beat four, so you have you, you don't have an ending consonant. So we're gonna do what we call a breath release. You. You. If I was putting my voice on it, I would say you, but of course it's not voice. So we just go you, and I let my lips release there. It's called a breath release. One, two, three, four. Return to you. One, two, three, four. Return to your life. And that's how we get that nice clean cutoff. On the long notes in jazz, we want to make sure we're keeping the energy moving forward. And maybe it's not going to crescendo, but it's that, just that feeling of forward motion that we're looking for in all music. As you get a little higher on the third and fourth phrase, I'm going to sing the bass part right now, but it does kind of explode a little bit on us. And as we get up there, you want to just make sure you're nice and light and that you're mixing in your head voice with your chest voice. Come back to your past. Come. Little bit of chest voice in there. Quite a bit of head voice, too. Come back to that time that went so fast. And you notice there I'm accenting that, and then I'm doing almost like a sforzando piano and crescendo to really get the edge on that lyric right there.
The moon is quick. It chases us.
So now that we've got our basic relaxed warm, intimate, approachable vocal jazz tone happening in the beginning of this, of course, it's not going to stay like that the whole piece. It is going to grow and develop, and eventually we are going to add a little more presence into it, certainly more volume and dynamics. We just do that by supporting the air a little more and making the tone just a little brighter as it gets louder. So I'm going to sing the bass part at letter C, for example. You'll just hear it open more. One, two. I search the sky. The stars could hold the answers. Again, I'm not trying to do big chest voice as it goes up above the bass clef staff there. I'm thinking buoyancy. I'm thinking a lifted vocal tone, something that is literally uplifting both the lyric and the vocal tone as we get into it. The next page, measure 51. But the sky may cry. I'm going to put a little cry in. I'm going to paint that lyric right there and then pull back. And drench me with all the answers.
I search the sky. The stars could hold the answers. But the sky may cry. And drench me with all the answers. I think you're losing yourself. But I'll wait till you find yourself. Not going anywhere without you. I won't let you fall away. There's too much to throw away. Don't know what I'd do without you.
And as you look into the second verse, it gets even better. I see your smile, haven't seen it in a while, which is like everybody's experience coming out of masking, right? I hear your voice inside my head. Think of all the things that you've said.
I see your smile. Haven't seen it in a while. I hear your voice inside my head. Think of all the things that you said.
So you want to go through this piece phrase by phrase. Really think about what words do we want to bring out and put a little extra tone or a little extra inflection to the syllables and words that you want to emphasize.
The sun is bright. Blinds us from the truth of night. I know you're here. I hope that you know I'm still here.
All right, we're going to move on to page 7, letter K. And you can see just by looking at the lyrics that this is the bridge of the song. The lyrics say, sifting through the fog, I see the road clear up ahead. Love is all around you, and I know you, and you might take that road instead. But you won't take that road because I'm going to stay here until you come to your senses, and I'm going to stay here, and I'm not going anywhere without you, right? Eventually, the chorus resolves the tension of the lyric. But right now, you're going to feel the rhythm section get much more intense here. The piano's playing busy eighth notes. The drumming is getting more intense. And so our tone has to reflect that. I'm going to sing the soprano melody just down an octave so you can hear that intense. Sifting through the fog. So a little more urgency, a little more presence in my tone. Fog. We're just going to let that fall off very, very quickly. So that it doesn't detract from the lyric. Next phrase, I see the road clear up ahead. You also notice like my face went here, and that's because the chord there features an intense dissonance between the tenors and the altos. So even though I'm on the soprano part here, the whole choir has to have that tense, intense, sound shooting right out of your upper front teeth there. Then the next lyric, love is all around you, goes from 4-part intense dissonance to 2-part in 6. So, of course, we're going to relax the vocal tone. Love is all around you, and I know you, and you might take that road instead. So you're kind of mixing in the colors of your tone as you navigate this bridge.
Without you.
night till you find yourself. I'm not going anywhere. Without you, I won't let you fall away. There's too much to throw away. Don't know what I'd do.